LeBron James! LeBron James! LeBron James! LeBron James.
born in the late 1800s, and from grandmother's grandma, who was a slave. And when you're a slave, you're owned. You don't choose if you're owned. When you're a slave, you're deprived of education. It's not choice, that's by force. So, I understand the need to have free thought, but if your thoughts aren't researched, that is just going to hurt those that are still in conditions where it's not choice that when they go down the street, there's a liquor store and fast food restaurants, and your education is not being funded the same way it is in Calabasas. So that statement was one of the most ignorant statements that anybody that came from the hood could ever say about their ancestors, that slavery is a choice. What are you talking about?
Look here, I know Kanye's bugging the fuck out. He wrong for the shit he's saying. But I ain't gonna let that distract me from the real news that's going on. It's a distraction. North and South Korea are reunited after all this goddamn time. What are they gonna do next? Are they coming over here to holler at us? Because we got this crazy orange-ass nigga in the White House. H&M still out here calling niggas monkeys. Police still abusing and killing.
Bluetooth mode.
I got to run it back.
With none of us, every day shaking the earth like I'm juggling up. Fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up. Got to be jumping like you playing double duck. Dalai Lama with the beat, we fix the problems, let it blow. Hold your comments, don't get silence on some mob of shit. Whoa, all my fans say I'm the greatest, like Muhammad, bitch. Whoa, we don't pay that, we ain't saying that one more time. No, we just pull up to my door, fuck them out like dick they told. They get right back to the door, we say the lawyer, no one knows. Hit my nigga, stand up for the zittles, that's the drone. If you ain't the fan, then you can't get it, that's for sure. Yo, hop back on the track, might get the real. I told my pastor, I'm the savior. Rapper back, it's like a sailing trap. We have to stack the paper with no labor, but still need your arm. Y'all just imitated, but this y'all know you can't fade it off.
That's right. Teammate to teammate. That's my man's. I just got traded to Boston. As I redo this again. Kawhi. Another one? Let's go, Kyrie. And we do that all season long, baby. No, you ain't. I'll take that before that three any day. That shit has been green, green, green. Green, you know what I mean? That shit been green, you know what I mean? Oh shit, I missed him. Good shot. Let's go. Jump ball on Blake ass. Okay. Damn, Ben. I was stuck in the middle of the middle. Nah, not this time, sir. Come on now. What was that about? I mean, he pulling up. I know it. 10. You pulling up? I hit them, Russell. Ooh. Turn over. There you go. I told you, turn
She my number one, I don't need nothing on the side. Said that I was down for good and don't want no more lies. But my phone be blowing up, temptations on my line. I stare at the screen a while before I press decline. But she plants a seed and it still lingers in my mind. Told myself I'm strong enough to shake it and I'm trying. But I'm only human, I know love ain't use a crime. If I take this cookie now, one day I'll do the time.
Slip me a zenny at once. I got the earth and the blunt. I get the skirt when I want. I get the skirt when I want. Due to the money aroma. My girl, she got a diploma. She got white written all over. She got white written all over. All I need to know is how to fuck a good thing up. Run from the pain, sip lean, smoke tree up. When I'm in your town, press town, hit me up. When I'm in your town, press town, hit me up. Only if you down and you slurp your D up. If the work good, I'll be back for the re-up. Hate when I creep in the phone, wake me up. Fake like I'm sleep, knowing damn well I be up. Money on my back, then I walk 100 miles. You make a nigga feel fake when he smile. Love be confused in the mind of a child. Love wouldn't lie like I lie, and it's wild. Wanna have my cake and another cake too. Even with the bacon, don't bake like you. Even when the flavor don't taste like you. So I'm back mobbing with the late night crew.
The Kevin Hart situation.
Oh my God.
Everybody's talking about Ooh. It, and we want to hear from you. We're talking about this all day.
Oh, yeah. All in your mind, what fears that would come true? Back in my mind, back in my mind was you. Wishing that I could blind myself from you. Only advice for you. Slip me a zenny at once. I got the perfect blunt. I get the skirt when I want. I get the skirt when I want. Due to the money aroma. My girl, she got a diploma. She got white written all over. She got white written all over. I'm a fake nigga and it's never been clearer. Can't see myself when I look in the mirror. Can't see myself when I look in the mirror. Can't see myself when I look in the mirror. I'm a fake nigga and it's never been clearer. Can't see myself when I look in the mirror. Can't see myself when I look in the mirror. Can't see myself when I look in the mirror.
She my number one, I don't need nothing on the side. Said that I was down too good and don't want no more lies. But my phone be blowing up, temptations on my line. I stare at the screen a while before I press decline. But she plants a seed and it still lingers in my mind. Told myself I'm strong enough to shake it and I'm trying. But I'm only human, I know love and you are crime. If I take this cookie now, one day I'll do the time.
I love her, I don't wanna lose her. I'm selfish, I know that I use her. My ego gets stroking, I bruise her. My ego gets stroking, I bruise her. My actions, I know they confuse her. At home, I'm the happy as usual. On the road, I'm a Mac, I'm a chooser. I'm an addict, I'm asking the truth.
Yo, Kev.
What, man?
Hey, man, look, nobody's perfect. And you're only human. Learn from it, man. Just learn from it. You know what I'm saying?
He didn't wash his hands. I got dick hands on my jacket now.
Tell me what's done in the dark, we'll find a way to shine. I done did so much that when you see, you might go blind. What's done in the dark, we'll always find a way to shine. I done did so much that when you see, you might go blind.
Dude, I mean, your freedom, your respect,
The record actually happened. It's the fastest record I've ever recorded in my life. You know what I'm saying? It happened at the end of a 4-hour-long discussion.
I'm sure there were a lot more things you could have been saying on that song. Oh,
man, I mean, I said it, you know, I said it. But the discussion happened from the time I got there up until the time we started recording.
But let's talk about the discussion. You see this Twitter rampage.
No, I'm talking about you got there first.
And how you see that Twitter rampage.
Because you hadn't talked to them.
Yeah, I hadn't talked to Ye, man, since I got out of prison. Like, we did the record for No Mercy, and then I had, you know, probably hadn't spoke to him much since I probably got out of prison.
That's like, what, 6-7 years?
Yeah, something like that. Wow. I mean, you know, I don't know if we may have seen each other in passing, but I hadn't, you know, we hadn't had an actual conversation in, you know, quite some time. So we happened to see each other at a hotel lobby in L.A. I was there for a meeting, he was there for a meeting, he came over and spoke to him, and, you know, so then immediately I said, man, let's work.
God put you there for a reason at that time.
You know, he said that to me several times. He said that to me. He's like, man, you are here for a reason. Mm-hmm. He said that. He's expressed that. But, so, you know, I said, let's work. He said, yeah, bet. He gave me his number. He put out a phone, and it was all like, because I never knew him to have a phone. Mm-hmm. I remember, like, it was a big deal. And we were recording in Hawaii that, you know, like, he ain't got no phone. He don't do no phone. So he got, like, that.
I don't recall.
It was a flip phone, okay? I'm certain it was an iPhone. But anyway, so, you know, we exchanged numbers. He went back about his meeting, I went back about mine. Then that night, you know, I went to the studio, and, you know, after I left him, I started seeing the stuff, you know. It just started popping up. And then, so by the next morning, I got on the phone with him again, you know, another weird turn of events that is not really relevant to the story, so I'm going to continue on past it, but I hit him and said, hey, yo, let me get with you, you know what I'm saying, I want to get with you whenever I can, and he immediately hit me back and was like, I bet, I have my people calling, you know, instead of me.
And this is after the Trump.
It was right around the time when John Legend had hit him. You know what I'm saying? Like, and so I'm, you know, and I'm like, hey, yo, what's going on, bro? But I didn't want to say nothing over the phone because I have an opportunity to go see him. So I'm not going to, you know, have a discussion over the phone. And you know what I'm saying? It's a huge complex, a compound, whatnot. You know, you get me in, and, you know, we walk past security and whatnot, and he takes me into, you know, his showrooms, and, you know, you see all the new Yeezys and the season, probably season 13, 14, and now I'm thoroughly impressed, you know what I'm saying? I congratulate him, I know he's working hard, I'm thoroughly impressed. I'm like, I want to be like, yo, when them come out, I'm like, Tip, you must stay focused.
Right, gotcha.
You are in here on a mission.
Gotcha. You
must stay focused. And so we go on into the room where, you know, everybody was sitting and there was music and whatnot. And so he said, you know, he starts saying, you know what I'm saying, I got some things that, you know, I want to play for you, want you here. I say, can't wait to do it. But first, let me speak to you right quick. But we stepped outside, we had a discussion. And that's when I was like, yo, what's up, man? I'm sure you have, you know, a very logical explanation to all of this. Like, what's happening? What's the punchline?
And you give him the benefit of the doubt because it's Kanye. Like,
yeah, like, what's going on?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm sure you got something that's going to make all this make sense in my head. I just got to hear it.
Right.
So, let's hear it.
Go.
Let's go. Right. And he say, man, just being a free thinker, man.
what do you think about? Well, go ahead.
And I'm like, huh? What do you mean a free thinker? Like, man, I'm just feel free, you know, I just felt free to think whatever it is that my mind leads me to think without some monolithic view of what society wants me to think. I'm like, what's up with the hat, bro?
Right.
And he's like, man, my subconscious spoke to my conscious and it just moved me to wear the hat, but yo, like, you know what the hat represent? He's like, not when I wear it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you want to repurpose it. Yeah, it's not.
He like, just like we did the word nigga, we took the power from the word, and now we use the word as our own. I said, yeah, that's not the same. Mm-hmm. That's not the same, bro.
Because America's never been great for minorities, yeah. So you can't make it great again.
And I
and
asked
we have
the
a
man,
who's currently trying to strip us of all these rights
but just
right now.
But just imagine, like, right now, I'm really, like, looking, and I'm trying not to trip. And plus, it's Kanye. He doesn't seem like malicious or
not at all.
If,
right.
You know what I mean? It seems extremely sincere and passionate.
Not a publicity stunt.
Nah, it don't seem like it's nothing he doing. It seems like the man just woke up on some shit one day. I didn't get no signs of no. Right. You know what I'm saying?
You think he's just
no inebriated state of mind?
Uninformed about politics, maybe not
like
really knowing what's going on when it comes to the world right now.
I don't know, man. But what I do know is, I asked him two things. Right? I said, and then, wait a minute, before I ask him this, he said, yo, Khalil Kweli and wore a Rockefeller chain, and they booed me when I came out on stage for wearing it. Like, as far as my style, but it's, like, around, I say, bro, do you really think that is the same thing?
Mm.
He's like, yeah.
Wow.
I say, no. Nah. Ain't the same thing at all. And then, you know, after he said that, I said, well, look, man, have you thought about the people who supported you that you hurt when you put the hat on? And then he looked different. You know what I'm saying? He looked at me kind of like, I could see an epiphany. And, you know, he was like, what, hurt someone for having my own opinion? I say, yeah, people believe in you and they see you as a certain way. And then you go and they support you and you support someone who goes directly against them. Like, you supporting the enemy. So, do you think how they feel? He's like, no, I didn't think about that. But I could see in his face, he was like, right. I don't want, that ain't what I ain't mean to do that.
You know what I'm saying? I don't want to speak too much, but he actually hit me and said, hey, man, T.I. said I'm hurting people. Am I hurting people? I'm like, nigga, yes.
Hey, man.
What do you think it is? What do you think
it is?
And
then Charlamagne hit me and say, hey, if you were Kanye, you talking to him, whatever you say, keep saying.
For real, because it was getting through to him.
But can't you see from all the responses from everybody how much it hurts?
What do you think he listens to that?
No, I'm not listening.
Yeah, listen to that.
His superpower is his weakness. Because you got to think, people telling him what he can't do.
Right.
And then him keep pushing and making it is what
got him where he is. That's what got us Jesus Walk.
Yes.
Nobody was doing the song like Jesus Walk. Everybody, I told him, man, you tripping with that one. He like, okay, watch this. You know what I'm saying? With the same resilient energy but when he say his subconscious talk to his conscious, and it moved him to do something. Like, I disagree with it, but the last thing I'm going to ever do is tell somebody not to listen to themselves.
Right? Mm-hmm.
If it's something inside of yourself saying to do something, even if I don't agree with it, I don't feel comfortable telling someone to listen to me over listening to themselves.
What if that's Damani wearing a Make America Great Again?
Man, that ain't gonna never gonna happen. I ain't gotta worry about that. All my kids.
Like, it's my subconscious.
Hey, man. Hey, man. That's the thing, though. That's a grown ass man.
What's blinding him? Like, what is he not seeing? Is it his people around him? Because, you know, if I do something, Charlamagne gonna slap me in the back of the head, you know?
What is he not seeing?
That's what I'm lost about.
I mean, I don't even think he's even challenged this idea, or this idea has been challenged aside from when it hit the air. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, the fact that it moved me enough, and we as the black delegation cannot afford to lose Kanye West. I'm gonna keep it out with a thousand. That was my approach. I'm like, nah, hell nah. We can't do that.
And I know he's influential, but I didn't realize how influential. Because people crying over it. Like, people literally on social media and kids.
He is our Michael Jackson. Like, just point blank period. And I feel like the same consideration we give Michael Jackson. First of all, we're talking about Kanye West here.
Yes.
It's very, 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 I'm talking about a minuscule percentage of the population of the earth that speaks the language of Kanye West.
Right.
The things that come into his mind once it hit the air, it probably don't sound the same to the person, the average motherfucker who listened to it, as it did in his head.
Right.
So he needs kind of like a translator, for real.
Yeah, really. That's,
like, he needs somebody around him who he can say stuff to, and then they can say what he's saying is he trying to do this. And I mean, if you just take seconds of him speaking and play it, sounds preposterous. But if you listen to him over a span of 3-4 hours,
you understand.
You kind of understand his logic and where he's coming from. You don't agree with it. I emphatically disagree.
Like, if he says, I love Trump, he don't mean he loves Trump, look, his policies, man. His ideology.
Nah, it's kind of like,
he
like, style. Like, I love fried chicken. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's kind of like, I love him. You know what I'm saying? I love Coachella. Hell yeah. He don't think of him as a person. He's thinking of the thought, thing that, whatever that force is. And then he say, well, he has dragon energy. I have dragon energy. I say, what the fuck is a dragon got? You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And, but like, that was like the beginning of the conversation.
Right.
So I'm just hearing him throw all these parables and like the man speaking in kind of like riddles and shit. You know,
because he can't really explain.
He can't explain himself. The shit that's going on in his head.
Yeah,
but the more he talk it out, he kind of get around to it. So by the time we had sat down in the room with everyone else, he kind of got around to trying to, like, now he can kind of convey. Because, you know, that when I said, because he said, well, I don't agree with everything he said. I don't agree with half of the stuff he said. I said, okay, well, what part do you agree with?
Right.
And he said, well, the thought of coming from nothing and nobody says you can do it and you become the president.
Was he nothing? No, he didn't really come. Donald Trump didn't come. I mean,
in the world of politics.
In the world of politics,
absolutely. In the world of politics, he was absolutely zero, less than, lesser than that. He was a reality star.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, Donald Trump would be equivalent to Kris Jenner becoming the president of the United States of America.
And
it would be equivalent.
Because I still look at him as a very privileged individual, not as a...
Did you hear what I said?
Right,
it would be like Kris Jenner being the president of the United States.
So how did it end? You said that was part, like, so how did it end? Did he finally get it? Said,
I think he understands the optics of the situation because he don't understand how dire this situation
is.
He knows nothing about Trump's policies.
I asked him, man, I said, hey man, so how you feel about the travel ban? He said, what's the travel ban?
Exactly.
It doesn't affect him. And sometimes,
you know what I'm saying? So I said,
him.
Come on, bro. You can't do this. You can't do this, man. You can't side with somebody. And you say you leading with love. Like, if you loving this man is hurting all these people, What make him so much worth so much love to where it caused these people so much pain?
You love someone who hates.
And then he sat down. I ain't figured that out. I gotta figure that out. And then he started thinking. And then he was like, but if... You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
now
yeah.
He's trying to reconfigure his approach. You did? And
you can tell T.I. got a lot of kids, too, because, see, these are questions that kids ask, and you know, you got to be patient with them, because most people would have snapped by them.
We're only patient because it's Kanye.
I know, that's the thing. So now what if he's going to put out his album, but he's already, he meets Trump, and he's like, I love him.
What
and
you
he's
mean?
Been, like, let's
but
just
I,
say.
He loves the thought of, he loves if Donald Trump would have made it the way he is, the way he made it, and you know, he defied all odds, and he was really a decent human being. You know, if that were the case, because in his mind, that's, you know, that's kind of how it is.
Yeah.
He don't really know nothing.
Right.
He don't know the things that we know because he's removed himself from society to the point where it don't reach him. He said he just started watching CNN.
He said even when Obama was in the White House, he never watched CNN or nothing. He said he just started watching CNN.
So are we excusing this?
No, we're not excusing this.
No. Hell no. It actually makes it more dangerous, the fact that you're uninformed and you're using your platform to spread this.
Now, the genius of them said, all right, well, let's do a song. Like, how did the song come about?
Man, because we were talking for 4 hours about the same thing. I have never. But it was a very enlightening discussion, I feel like. You know, I learned a lot. I learned a lot, you know, about him and, you know, about his commitment to personal growth. He's truly committed, and whatever that is, like, he feel like he on a personal journey. Just give him, he like, man, look, man, just give me a minute. I'm feeling something. I'm work. Let me, you know, let me figure out what it is, you know. Don't be so quick to just cut me out. I'm not a white supremacist. I don't agree with white supremacy. Mm-hmm. I say, but you are supporting one.
You wearing their flag.
You are wearing the flag.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? He's like, but imagine what a white supremacist thinks about it when I wear it. He'll want me to take it off. I say,
so do we.
And I'm like, well, do him a favor. You know what I mean? Just take it out, because we want you to take it out, everybody. And then he's like, man, maybe you want me to take it off and them want me to take it off is enough to bring y'all closer together. I'm like, man, listen.
Bro. All right.
Do you think what he's attempting to do can be done?
My head.
Who? You, man, listen, man. My brother's coming with a love, bleed with love, Martin Luther King. You know, early Martin Luther King. Martin Luther King before he got to see what's really real.
Yes, Martin before he sat with Elijah, saying, absolutely.
And I'm more Malcolm X. A lot more Malcolm X. To where I don't apply love to those that don't deserve it. It must be reciprocated. It must be earned first and then reciprocated. I ain't just loving for the sake of it. You know what I mean? I got children and family to love. I ain't just loving no hateful strangers.
I don't understand why black people, we the only people they tell to do that. We the ones that gotta love, and we gotta love our oppressors.
I ain't going for that.
Forgive our oppressors.
I ain't going for that.
How did the song come about? Whose idea was it? Like, okay.
You know, to the point where we've been going back and forth for quite some time, and we would start talking about music. He played the Scoop, Scooby Doo. And I say, man, you're just toying with people now. You gotta stop. Like, why are you doing this? And he like, nah, man. We're like, what if I go boop boop? I'm like, man,
stop it, man.
When I heard it, I said, what the fuck is this? And he told me it was a reference track,
bro.
I didn't know.
But look though, I think the shock of the people in the room every time he played it is what made him keep it. I think. And then, you know, hey, have y'all ever heard y'all seen that Dave Chappelle stand up? On Netflix.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The one where he says, you know, the reason why I really want to quit comedy, because I'm too damn good at this shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I can say any joke, any punchline, and, you know, y'all gonna laugh at it.
Right.
I feel like that's how Kanye feels.
I can make any song.
You know what I'm saying? I can make any song, y'all gonna like it. So it really don't matter what I do. I ain't pushing myself. I'm not bringing the best out of myself, because anything I do, you accept it and love it.
Because people were like,
right.
I love this track.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
It was, yeah. But I'm just saying, man, that Scoop-Scoopity-Boo bullshit is going to be a genre now. It's going to be a bunch of Scoopity-Boopity-Boopers.
Hey, you know like what I'm saying? Don't they call it like scat music?
I don't know what the fuck that shit was called, man. I could do without
it. I feel like
I did not care for it. However, he played some other shit that is completely like jamming on the one.
Hell yeah.
You know, so he played that first one for a reason.
Right.
Because he could have played any of these other songs that I heard that was jamming like a motherfucker. And then afterwards, I asked him if he had any beats or something like that. And then he was like, well, I got this one song. And you know what? I'm already kind of saying my part. Maybe we could, you know, it's kind of one-sided. Maybe you could do your part in between my parts. And I was like, shit, all right, cool. But then when I started doing my part, he just erased all of it and started from the top. So none of the stuff he told me he had that he keep, he just like started all the way over and we just freestyled back and forth. And it only took about 30 to 45 minutes to knock it out right quick.
It's interesting how God worked though, because when I heard the record, I was like, everybody gonna think it's a publicity stunt.
Yeah.
Because y'all just recorded it last
year. We released it in 24 hours.
You didn't know you were putting it up?
I didn't know. See, I did the song, right? I'm thinking after I leave, he gonna play the song back. He gonna hear me talking. You know what I'm saying? Right. I'ma still be talking to him while I'm gone.
Yeah.
And then he gonna hear what I'm saying. He ain't gonna like that shit. He gonna erase it. And then your man put the song out the next day.
He didn't give you a heads up or nothing.
Just nah, he didn't tell me nothing. But I mean, I don't know if he put it out. He said it got leaked. Oh. So you know.
But, with the boycotts you've been staging with Houston and everything, how do you know when it's time to let up off of business?
You did let up.
How do you know when it's time?
We resolve our issue. We, you know what I mean? We mediate. We come to the table, we sit down and have a discussion, you know what I'm saying? I speak for the collective, the greater good of the collective and their list of demands and requests. And, you know, we compromise back and forth and finally we shake hands on a agreed upon resolution. And, you know, everybody walk away a little happy, you know what I'm saying? Happier than they were before they walked in.
That's the goal, to make a change.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you also have your competition series on BET coming.
Yeah, man, the Grand Hustle.
The Grand Hustle.
Man, well, I just got a bunch of cats, man. Some who were formerly educated in Ivy League schools and some who were like hustlers from the streets. Mm-hmm. And I put them all in the house together and made them compete, man. You know.
bad jump, bad, bad, bad jump. Thank you. Oh shit, now. Thank you. Well, I tried it.